Mathematicians estimate that its invention has saved over 80,000 lives. It has prevented hundreds of thousands, if not millions, more injuries. One of the more underappreciated inventions, the caution wet floor sign was invented in Woonsocket, Rhode Island in 1922 by school custodian Vladimir Jackson. Vladimir's son, Milton Jackson.
Back then, when a janitor mopped the floor, he'd have to stand in the area until it dried. And make sure everyone who walked by walked carefully, so they didn't slip. Well, one day in 1919, my father just mopped the floor outside the faculty bathroom at Woonsocket Elementary when he got word of an emergency. Turned out a raccoon had gotten in through an open window in the gymnasium. My father figured if he got rid of the raccoon quickly, he'd get back to the slippery hallway before the class period ended and people started walking without caution on a recently mopped floor. He ran back from the gymnasium as quickly as he could, but he was just in time to see an entire second grade class slip and shatter their femurs simultaneously.
After the incident, Vladimir Jackson was a changed man. He realized there had to be some way for the school's only custodian to tend to an emergency, even if a floor he had recently mopped was not yet dry. Over the next 3 years, Jackson developed the caution wet floor sign, putting an end to broken femurs and inefficient janitors. Jackson's former colleague and current midget, Patrick Von Krapp.
Vladimir changed the way we got things done at Woonsocket. He was a genius. Soon every school, shopping mall, airport, hotel lobby had Vlad's sign. It was flawless.
But it wasn't flawless. It was only a matter of time before the caution wet floor sign's greatest pitfall was exposed in a classic case of the solution becoming the problem.
Poughkeepsie, New York, November 23rd, 2009. Hacky Sacks Incorporated employee James Sanducci hurries from his office cubicle to a board meeting down the hall.
He's running late to the biggest corporate presentation of his 18-year career, but he feels confident as he skims over his notes on the way to the board meeting.
So I just finished mopping the floor and after an intern spilled a whole pot of coffee. Like always, I put the caution wet floor sign right at the edge of where the floor was all slippery and junk. But that would not miss the Sanducci. Not that day.
But it wasn't the newly waxed linoleum that spelled trouble for Sanducci. The culprit? The caution wet floor sign.
Well, sure, there was a sign there to warn me about the wet floor. But what, I ask you, was supposed to warn me about the sign?
What was supposed to warn Sanducci about the sign?
It was this question that served as the foundation for one of our generation's greatest lawsuits, Sanducci v. Hacky Sacks.
Sanducci's legal team contested that there should have been some sort of warning that such an obvious roadblock had been placed in his way and sued Hacky Sack Incorporated for $4.8 million. Presiding judge, the Honorable Hector Malcolm Jenkins III.
For me, the case was pretty clear-cut from the beginning. The man had gone through extensive physical and emotional trauma and therefore deserved every dollar he asked for.
The case of Sanducci v. Hacky Sack blazed its way into eternal infamy, as not only did Sanducci win the highly disputed case, but Judge Hector Malcolm Jenkins III also took the opportunity to mandate new safety protocol. On every floor that was mopped or waxed, there would have to be a caution wet floor sign and a caution wet floor sign.
The caution wet floor sign was the only way I could be sure the pedestrians would be safe from both the slippy, sliding nature of a freshly cleaned floor and the protruding, often overlooked danger of his corresponding sign.
While Sanducci and Jenkins believe wholeheartedly in the benefits of the caution wet floor sign, some have been harder to convince. Social theorist, Dr. Theodore Child Molester.
It is simply preposterous, and I have truly no idea how no one else sees it this way. I mean, what if someone trips over the caution wet floor sign? Then what is the Honorable Judge Jenkins going to decree then? A sign warning passers-by that sign? And then what? If they trip over that sign, another... I refuse to be a social theorist in a world with a caution, 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 wet floor, signs, 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 signs.
The legend of the caution, caution, wet floor sign sign is one of many layers. How are we to know how events would have unfolded had they fallen just a little differently? Who's to say in this American epic how things would have turned out had that raccoon not gotten into the Woonsocket Elementary Gymnasium back in 1919? And what of the hacky sack intern? What if she hadn't spilled that pot of coffee? And what about the judge, Hector Malcolm Jacobs III? What if he were a real ordained judge, and not just a PCP addict with a very authoritative voice? Till next time, I'm Jeff Jefferjeff, saying, things didn't happen that way, so get off my back about it. Good night.
Can't sleep.